Welcome to Top 5 with Joey Cassata. Starring Joey Cassata.
Team Jesus, my friend.
No! Am I walking around, Park?
Co-starring Ernie Palooza. Now here's your host, Joey Cassata.
All right, everybody, welcome back to Top 5 with Joey Cassata. I'm your host, Joey Cassata.
And I'm Millie Vanilli.
Millie Vernie.
Yeah, even better.
You know, Millie Vanilli gets a bad rap these days. Everyone's lip syncing now. You know, they should get that Grammy back that they had to give back.
They should take it.
How are you today, Ern?
I am great. Excited for tonight's episode. It's going to be good.
That shirt is very, very, very nice. It's kind of in the mood of today's episode, which is the top five songs that we love, but we're too embarrassed to admit it.
Perfect.
Now, this is your topic, Ern. I think it's one of my favorite topics we will ever do, maybe ever. This was one of the hardest topics for me because I didn't realize how many songs that I actually love that fit this topic.
Tell me about it.
So, again, when we say that we're embarrassed to admit it, I like to think of more, I think people would be very surprised that we like these songs, or especially me. I think people, you know, people think I'm a rock guy, I'm a Zeppelin, Kiss, you know, guy. So I think when they hear some of these picks that, and these are not picks that I'm just doing because of this show. These are actual songs that I listen to very, very frequently. How about yours?
I would argue that Kiss falls into this category.
You son of a bitch. Nobody's embarrassed of Kiss. What are you talking about?
Oh, sorry.
All right. So let's start with our number five pick, right? You go first, Mr. Palooza.
Okay. I'm going to go, even though you promised you're not recording this. I know this is not being recorded.
No, of course
okay.
not.
Okay. All right. This is just for us. Okay. My number five. Call Me Maybe.
I threw a wish in the well. Don't ask me, I'll never tell. I looked to you as it fell, and now you're in my way. Hey, I just met you, and this is crazy, but here's my number, so call me maybe.
Almost made my list. Go ahead.
And I still think it's amazing how great the keyboard sounds in the chorus. It's simple. It's even it's simpler than Jump from Van Halen. I mean, it's nothing almost, but it still sounds great to me. I think this song could have come out any time in history and it would have been a hit. It just, it sounds like, who knows where, nobody can even tell what it came from. It's always been around, it sounds like. I mean, I have to say, there's a few singers out there I like better, you know, Gaga, Kesha, Selena Gomez, but none of them came out with a song as catchy as this one. Not yet.
I love it. I love this song. Great pick. It's so funny you said this pick because my wife and I, we were talking about these types of songs last night trying to compile my list. And Call Me Maybe was the very first song my son was obsessed with as a kid. He loved, loved, loved this song. He loved the video. He loved the song. Loved everything about it.
Video's great.
Okay, great pick, great start. So my number five pick, I'm going to go with a song from a movie that I love. And it's What a Feeling from Flashdance by Irene Cara.
Sure.
Hurts when there's nothing but a slow glowing dream that your fear seems to hide deep inside your mind.
Thank you.
good one.
Now, again, I am not embarrassed to admit it. I love this song. I love the message. I think the movie is phenomenal. What a great, great movie. But I'm a sucker for these types of songs. Obviously, you know, we're both 80s guys. We grew up in the 80s. But I'm kind of a sucker for these feel-good, you know, pump-me-up type songs, you know, songs from Rocky. You know, my favorite song of all time is Eye of the Tiger. So this is right along those lines. You know, what a feeling, believe in yourself, your dreams, and all that stuff. So I'm a real sucker for these types of feel-good, you know, believe-in-yourself songs. Every time this song is on, if I hear it, there's no chance I'm changing the channel. That's how I know I love it.
It's a great one. That's a great tune.
All right, Ern, your number four.
My number four. I have a feeling we're going to be hearing from this one again as well. Wannabe by the Spice Girls.
Yo, I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want. So tell me what you want, what you really, really want. I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want. So tell me what you want, what you really, really want. I wanna really, really, really wanna zig a zig.
If you want my future, forget my past. If you wanna get with me, better make it fast.
Yes. I loved this group. I mean, looking back, each week I would have a crush on a different one. Matter of fact, oh, wait a minute. I do have a great story that I got to tell. It's crazy to think that I thought like this once, but I once went to a book signing of theirs.
What do you mean you?
You're coming down here to make Scary Spice my girlfriend. I must have been going through a real confidence high or something at this time. I don't know how to explain this. Anyway, on the way there, as you just pointed out, I picked up you. If I'm remembering this right, you were coming just so Posh wouldn't be lonely. Well, we were late. By the time we got there, it was over. I remember asking the security guard, are they gone? And he said yes. And then I asked, I can't believe I asked this, all of them?
He's not lying, people. I was standing next to him as plain as day.
Like, I would have been good with any of them. Basically, I didn't care. Who the hell did I think I was?
We're here for the Spice Girls signing. Are they here? They just left. All of them?
Let's be honest, though. Who the hell did I think I was? Old Spice?
Listen, I think you had a shot. What are you talking about? That's why I was along for the ride. Great pick. Now, is this, I don't, now obviously we went to the book signing. Was that before or after we went to see Spice World in the movies too?
I have to look up when the book came out.
I got to tell you, I enjoyed that movie too. I thought it was a fun movie.
Roger Moore was in it.
love the Spice Girls. I actually had another one almost make my list. Say You'll Be There. I actually like that song. Wannabe is a little bit overplayed for me, obviously, but Say You'll Be There, it has one of the catchiest choruses ever. The only reason it didn't make my list because the chorus is off the charts, but all the other parts of the song are not great, so it almost made my list.
That's a great one too, yes.
I do like how we're kind of on the same wavelength here.
It's crazy.
Okay, so my number three. This is a song when
number four.
Oh, I'm sorry. My number four. I'm sorry. So my number four, this song, you're going to hear at every wedding. You're going to hear it at the end of the night. And when this song comes on, for some reason, I love it every time. And that's Last Dance by Donna Summer.
So let's dance, let's dance, let's dance, let's dance.
Love this song, obviously in that disco vein. You know, I could have picked probably five songs all from any genre, from the same genre, pop, 80s pop, disco, whatever it is. I tried to mix it up a little bit just to kind of give you different flavors of what I do like and what I'm kind of embarrassed of too. But Donna Summer, Last Dance, It's just the perfect, you know, end of the night song. It starts off so sweet. Everyone is singing that part. And then obviously when Ernie gets out on the dance floor, the boogieing begins.
Well, I'm out there way before that. Yeah. That's a great song. Definitely.
Great. Yeah. Great. Again, these are songs I really do love. It's not something that I just every once in a blue moon will listen to. These are songs I put on regularly. All right, Erm, you're number three.
Number three is what I love this song. I love everything about it. Wake Me Up Before You Go-Go.
Ooh, good one.
Wake me up before you go-go. Don't leave me hanging on like a yo-yo. Wake me up before you go-go. I don't want to miss it when you hit that high. Wake me up before you go-go. Cause I'm not planning on going solo.
The memories of me jumping on my bed, making believe I was playing that huge guitar he has in the video, it's just too embarrassing to get into. Just me jumping around the bed, look at that, remember the monster guitar?
Of course.
You know something? I was thinking about it recently. I'm sure he regretted the line, I'm not planning on going solo.
Nicely done. Nicely done. Great song. Obviously, Wham is, Wham and all those bands from back then, Culture Club, all that stuff. I love all that stuff. I'm an 80s kid. All that pop stuff from the 80s, I absolutely love. So I think that's a great pick. You know, funny story, when we were on the Kiss tour with ZO2, at night, our good buddy Musk and myself, we would be driving in the middle of the night. Our shift was, you know, whatever, 2 a.m. to 6 a.m. Then that was our shift. So in the middle of the night, to not only torture the other guys in the band, but to kind of get our blood flowing to keep us awake, we would just play 80s pop hits constantly. That's all we would play. And everyone from the back of the bus would be screaming at us. But me and Musk would literally be screaming, you know, wake me up before you go-go in the middle of the night on the road on the Kiss tour.
I bet you Kiss loves it too.
Great. Listen, I think a good song is a good song. I don't care if it's pop, if it's country, if it's disco, if it's this guy, that guy. It doesn't matter to me. I think a good song is a good song.
Agreed.
Okay, so I kind of had my feel-good song. I went my disco song, which, you know, a lot of disco stuff I love. Saturday Night Fever is one of my favorite movies and records of all time. I love all that stuff. So now I'm going to go into my number three pick, which is kind of my ballad pick. And I'm a big, big ballad guy. Love sappy ballads. This ballad is I'll Be by Edwin McCain.
And I'll be your crying love suicide, and I'll be better when I'm older.
I was gonna say I'm not really aware of that one. I think
I'll play it for you. It's lovely. We'll hold hands. It'll be delightful.
It's very romantic.
But again, I love these types of songs. I love these big ballads. I love, you know, Richard Marx. I'll be waiting, and all these big 80s ballads. I'm just a sucker for it. I love that type of stuff. I'll Be is such a great song. There's even an acoustic version that Edwin McCain does that's phenomenal. Just one of those songs, especially like when you're in the shower and stuff, comes on. I'm singing at the top of my lungs. So it's just super fun, mushy, you know, sappy song.
You know, I think we could make a whole separate top five on sappy ballads, by the way.
Oh, absolutely. All right, Erm, your number two.
Okay. Let me see if you would even remember. I'll give you a hint. The Hamptons, the year 2000.
Does it have something to do with your shirt?
No, but you know, Manny got married this week. I did listen to that song again. It didn't make the list though, but it was up there. Came even closer was what was it? Every Time I Touch was actually way up there on my list too, but it didn't make it.
Oh, yes. I thought you were actually going to go with the Whitney song. When I saw her shirt, I thought you were going to go with it. Are you talking about us driving to the Hamptons? Is that where you're going?
No. I'm talking about me dancing in the Hamptons. Maybe you weren't there.
You know what? I'm not sure. Give it to me.
Oops, I Did It Again.
Oh, baby. Oops, I did it again. I've made
Remember, if you remember right before we started, I said, I have a song that's almost made my list. I didn't put it on because I knew you were going with it. And that's the one. I had a couple Britney songs on my list. That was the one I really wanted, but I knew you had to. I knew you had to do it. So good for you. I love it.
You want to feel disgusting?
Here we go. I already feel disgusting.
She was 19 when this one came out. Oh, wait, let me get worse now. Uh-oh. It was this song was 3 years after Hit Me Baby One More Time.
Oh my God.
Do the math.
Not good. Well, 19 is okay.
No, hold on. 3 years before that was
I don't do subtraction. You're the math teacher.
Oops. I prefer oops because the chorus has a great melody line. The words of the chorus, to me, I've argued this so many times. Nobody ever agrees with me, but I find something very complex with the words in the chorus. Like something falling in love with her was just an accident. She's not who you think she is. Not that innocent. Obviously, that's quoted in the song, but I thought that was a bit darker than what I expect from light teen pop. And as you know, I like it better that way.
Listen, I love all this teen pop stuff. I think, you know, in the 90s, when grunge took over, I was so anti-grunge because I just didn't like depressing music, dark music, just feel bad music. I really started to embrace all the 90s pop, and all of this stuff is the stuff that I wind up liking more than rock music throughout the 90s. I love this teen pop stuff. Is this the video with her in the red costume? Is that this video?
Oh, yeah.
I know you love that video.
Who doesn't?
Again, great. Yes. This is easily one of my favorite episodes ever. This is right along our lines. You and I can talk this type of stuff for hours. I'm so curious to hear people's response from this episode because I really believe no one will think that we like this type of stuff.
Let me hear what you got for number two.
Okay. So great, your great pick for number two. Like I said, it was on my list, but I knew you were going there. So right along the same category, I'm going to stay 90s teen pop. And who did it better than the Backstreet Boys? Am I right? Oh, and I got to go with I Want It That Way.
You are my fire, the one desire that I want it that way. Tell me why.
Oh, that was so close.
I mean, you know why, Ernie? You are my fire, the one desire. Oh, it's so good. I mean, I got chills. It's so good. It's such a great song. This one might be the closest to me being embarrassed to admit, but this one is, it's a phenomenal song.
There is memes all the time about this song when they show the bat catching the mosquito, and it says the bat uses sound to catch thing, and the bat sings the beginning, and the mosquito starts singing, goes, God damn it!
I've never seen that.
Oh, it's great.
But these songs, again, the boy bands of the 90s were so, so good. I mean, you had them, you had NSYNC, you had 98 Degrees, you had even Boyz II Men. All of that stuff is so, so catchy and good. I don't care. You know, people laugh at that stuff sometimes. They're just great songs. I don't know if they wrote the songs or there was, you know, producers writing the songs. I don't care. They were just great, catchy, poppy songs. And that's really the music that I like. I like pop music. I'm not a big heavy rock type fan. I like pop music, singable, melodic songs. That's what I like.
I remember one time in the Hamptons that we actually attempted to make our own boy band.
There's video out there somewhere. We had the moves and everything, right?
That was I don't know what we were doing that day. We had the whole a choreography and everything.
I could see it like it was yesterday. We were out by the pool. Obviously, we were drinking, And we were literally spread out like a boy band, you know, five of us, and we were doing all the moves. I don't even know, was it to even music or we were just doing moves?
I don't remember, but it shows how pop, how secretly we were all into it, that we were actually attempting to make one.
Absolutely. And we were all into, we all loved it secretly.
Yep.
Okay, so obviously we're at our number one choice, but before we get to our number one, let's leave them in suspense. I know you love to do the honorable mentions before we hit our number one. So
We gotta tease them.
So let's do, because this category is so loved by both of us, let's do two honorable mentions each. How's that sound?
It looks like you did four, but okay, two.
Well, two each. Two for you, two for me.
Okay.
So you start. Go ahead.
Okay, my first honorable mention is called Boom, 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 Boom by the Venga Boys.
Boom, 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 boom. I want you in my room. Let's spend the night together from now until forever. Boom, 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 boom. I want to go boom, boom. Let's spend the night together, together in my room.
How does that go again?
Boom, 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 boom. I want you in my room.
Hold on, keep going.
I don't remember the rest.
No, this is ratings delight. Let's go.
I mean, looking back, We Like to Party was the bigger hit. I do admit that. And, you know, with the ball guy dancing in that Six Flags commercial, this is all the same group, you know.
I didn't know that.
And they have another song, a better title, Rocket to Uranus, which has got the better song title. But I prefer this one. I think the sound is like the girl who sings Barbie Girl if she joined the Spice Girls. That's what the sound of this band makes me think.
I like that.
And the video is a real winner.
I vaguely know the song. I can't picture the video at all. I'm assuming I know why you like the video.
Well, not to get into details, since my wife is watching.
Uh-oh.
Let's just say it's entertaining.
Great choice. I don't know it that well, but it's a great choice. So again, I have so many of these songs on my list. I'm really choosing at the last minute. I don't know which way to go. I could go another boy band direction, but I'm not going to. Actually, that was kind of a pun on words, because I was going to go with a One Direction song. That's What Makes You Beautiful. I absolutely love that song.
That's a great song. Great
amazing song. I only reason I didn't go with it, because I just picked another boy band, but it would have easily made my list. But I'm going to go cheesy 80s pop instead. I'm going to go Corey Hart, Sunglasses at Night.
I wear my sunglasses at night so I can watch you weave them, breathe your storylines.
Such a great song. It's just... it's so ridiculous, but it's so catchy, so poppy, so singable. It's just everything there is about the 80s pop all rolled in one. Perfect, perfect song.
It's got a great sound in the background.
Yeah, it's just, you know, it screams 80s right from the very first note. So I love all that 80s pop. You know, you could put any of that stuff. Originally, I mean, I could make a whole list. I think we should even do a top five of just that 80s pop stuff, because there's so much on there, even the one-hit wonder type stuff that I could choose that easily could have filled my whole list. But like I said, I wanted to mix it up a little bit. Okay, your second honorable mention.
Well, my boy band time.
Oh, yeah.
Bye, bye, bye. And I just noticed my two honorable mentions are Bye 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 and Boom 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 Boom.
Bye 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 Boom Boom Boom.
This is the best boy band song ever. Better than Cover Girl by New Kids on the Block. Better than I Want It That Way by Backstreet Boys.
I gotta disagree. Gotta disagree. But go ahead. I respect the choice.
Timberlake seems to me like a real talented guy, although he made most of his money from writing the McDonald's jingle. I'm loving it. That's where most of his money really comes from.
Yeah, sure. But again, great choice. NSYNC, all those bands from the 90s, they're just fun bands. It's great music, fun songs. Was that their first song?
No.
Their first hit?
I Want You Back. Not the Jackson 5 song, though.
Right. So who was the first of the 90s boy bands? Was it Backstreet?
I'm going to guess. Backstreet was before NSYNC, definitely.
Right. And obviously New Kids was 80s.
Well, that's 80s, yeah.
Yep. So that revival, I think Backstreet kind of started that again.
I'll have to look it up. I think, you know, there was a Color Me Bad. I don't know if you want to count that.
Yeah, anyway. I remember them too. Yeah, sure. I don't remember any of the songs, but I do remember them. They didn't make my list. Sex you up. What is it?
I Want to Sex You Up.
Oh, how does that go again?
I don't remember. Oh. I'm just trying to embarrass me even more.
No, I'm just trying. I'm trying to get you to sing on camera. It's gold, baby, gold. Okay.
I really don't remember.
Okay. My second honorable mention. Again, this girl has so many great hits along the lines of Britney and stuff. And this one, as soon as I heard it, it's in my head today because I was listening to it earlier today too. I can't stop singing it. And that's California Girls by Katy Perry.
California girls were unforgettable. Daisy Dukes, bikinis on top. Sun-kissed skin so hot, we'll melt your popsicle. Oh, 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 oh,
oh. Such a great song. She has so many other songs too that are catchy, but what are you laughing at? I see you laughing.
I like Katy Perry.
It's
I love her at the beginning with California Girls, all those songs. Yeah.
So good. So catchy. Pure pop at its best. Just great, great catchy songs. Love the chorus is one of my favorite choruses ever. It's so hooky, so catchy. Like I said, that's the stuff that I love more than anything. I love those singable pop songs that you're in your car and you can just sing at the top of your lungs. Feel good, fun, upbeat music. That's what I love.
I hear you.
All right, now that we teased them, those were our honorable mentions. Let's get to number one. I hope we don't have the same number one. I have a bad feeling we do.
I don't think so.
Okay, good.
I really don't think so.
You first.
The guy who sings this might be the reason why cancel culture was originally made. Ignition Remix by R. Kelly.
Got me playing the field, so baby, give me that. And let me get that. Running her hands through my fro. Bouncing on 24s.
You know what? I don't know the song.
Oh. This song is one of my top 10 favorite songs of all time. And I gotta say, I feel sleazy saying that. Even though I have like 100 Prince albums, this made me feel sleazy saying that. I imagine pre-gaming with our crew singing, "It's the freaking weekend and I'm about to have me some fun."
Why don't I know this song? I don't remember it.
Wait, what anyway, if you say that, unless R. Kelly is there, then you probably should just get the hell out of there.
You don't want his weekend to start, you know, if you know what I mean. It's terrible.
The song is so good. When I was doing my, research, listening to all these songs, I had to listen to it over and over and over again. That's how much I love this song.
I wrote it down and I forgot to write remix. I will listen to it as soon as we sign off. I promise.
It's such a dirty, disgusting song by a dirty, disgusting person.
Right up your alley, you dirty, disgusting man.
Even the title. Even the title alone. Starting the call with putting the key in and hearing it. Oh, forget about it. It's all bad.
Like, my number one is the exact opposite. My number one is as bubblegum as you could possibly get. This is, you know, as clean cut and cutesy as possible. And I'm talking about, maybe you guessed it, Mbop by Hanson.
Yeah.
One of my favorite songs ever. What a great hook. What a great beat and just catchy chorus. Who the hell would ever think a song called Mbop would be a giant hit? And it is. And the funny part about that album, too, is there's so many other good songs on that record, too, that people forget about. And it really is a strong record all the way from top to bottom. You should go back and listen to it. Anyone who hasn't listened to that first Hanson record in a long time, just, again, bubblegum pop, hooky, catchy songs from the first song all the way to the end. But Mbop is, every time it comes on, when I start singing it and who's ever around me immediately starts laughing. I started singing it last night doing the research for this episode, and my kids are looking at me like I'm completely lost my mind. Because I'm trying to sing it in that high little kid voice that he has. I'm trying to sing it like that, and I'm singing the words. It's ridiculous, but so much fun.
There was so many choices all this time.
Oh, all right. You know what? If you had one more, Ern, if you had to choose one more.
I'll throw a couple out there. Cotton Eye Joe.
Oh, yeah.
Bobby Girl. Believe It or Not, I'm Walking on Air. There was so many.
Oh, don't you dare say that's embarrassing. That's one of the greatest songs ever.
Oh, my God. There was so many on my list.
Yeah, a couple of the ones that made my list, again, that we didn't talk about. Let's Hear It for the Boy, Denise Williams, Kenny Rogers, Lady, Physical, Olivia Newton-John. There's so many, again, from this genre that I absolutely love. And again, what's the genre? Is it pop? Is it feel good? It's really not. It's just everything. It's just good music that, for some reason, some of these songs, especially like the boy band stuff, they kind of get looked down upon. Why do you think that is?
It's because the way it looks, it's always been that way, though. I mean, look at Justin Bieber or look at Nickelback.
Yeah, you're right.
People make a choice and that's it. It sticks.
And you know what? You're right. But it's funny. I was always the opposite. I could never care what someone else thought of something that I liked, whether it was Kiss, whether it was comic books, Star Wars, whatever I liked, Dungeons and Dragons. I know we like Dungeons and Dragons, all of that stuff. And all along the lines of pop music too, even, breakdance music back in the early 80s. I loved, my brother makes fun of me still to this day. I used to love breakdancing and I used to bring my cardboard around with me to school. Yeah. We used to breakdance and stuff. It was just so much fun. There's no reason to ever be embarrassed of stuff that you enjoy. Who the hell is someone to tell you shouldn't enjoy something?
I remember the breakdancing, though, always turned into wrestling after a while with the cardboard.
Well, again, I think that might have led right into my wrestling phase. It went from breakdancing to wrestling. I think you're right.
A breakdancing wrestler.
I think there's a couple. Well, why do you think, if you remember very, very vividly, when we used to go out in the Hamptons, what did I used to do, in the bars at the end of the night?
The worm?
The worm. And it wasn't only from breakdancing. Obviously, I know how to do the worm because of breakdancing back in the 80s. And I could do a pretty good worm, admit it.
I could never figure it out. So, yeah.
But at the time when we used to go out to the bars all the time, there was a wrestler, Scotty Too Hotty, that would do the worm in the ring and then he would hit his opponent. So I kind of mixed both of those worlds. And so much fun. I used to kill myself the next day because I used to do them. I used to do the worm in that outdoor, bar we used to go to, the Bordy Barn, and it was concrete. And I used to wake up the next morning bloody, from in my chest and my knees and stuff, and I'd be like, what the hell happened to me? Worm on the concrete.
Bam.
Listen, I think today's topic was great. More than the topics between you and I and the discussions and stuff like that, I love to watch and hear other people's responses and choices to these lists. Like when we did the hair metal episode, I got so many people commenting on different bands that I either never heard of or I forgot about. So I love to hear and watch the discussion that happens when we do these crazy topics. And I can't wait to hear not only what people think of our picks and make fun of us, but what other people's picks are.
We're the fuse that sets off the powder keg.
And on that note, we're out of here, baby. Great time. Again, get over here. Do it.
Millie Vanilli.
Please give us and shoot us an email at top5withjoeycassata@gmail.com. Leave it in your comments on YouTube and on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram and wherever you could find podcasts. Give us a rating. Give us a 5-star rating if you can. Tell us what you think of the show. But more importantly, list your top five of the subject we're talking about today, which is top five songs that we love but are too embarrassed to admit. We want to hear your list. Ernie, great job today. I will see you next week for another fun list.